There's now a higher awareness for locally grown foods, meaning that more people want to buy them. Although one problem that they face is that they're not grown as close to home as they would like. Although what Winnipeggers don't know is that they actually are, because you can buy locally grown foods just like the ones around me at Fort White Alive at the farms. Fort White Farms, located inside Fort White Alive, is an urban farm working to make a difference in the local agriculture sector.
We are an urban farm, so we're kind of showcasing how we can raise food close to an urban center. One of the things that we focus on is promoting local food, sustainable food, and creating a relationship with your food. The greenhouse at Fort White Farms is a passive solar cold climate greenhouse. So it was designed for a cold climate in mind, so that when the sun is at its lowest point in the horizon on the winter solstice, it would have enough light in here and hit the back wall, heat up the space that's all made of concrete. And in the middle of the night, we wouldn't have to run the furnace as much because all of the hot air in that mass wall would radiate back into the air, helping warm the space. And therefore decreasing our hydro bills.
Danielle Mondor, the farm manager, oversees all operations at the farm.
This is the first year that we've really had a full operation going in the wintertime with raising pigs on pasture, as well as rabbits behind you, and our greenhouse is still functioning a little bit. So we're excited to start programs with youth at the beginning of February, and that's when we'll really kick it up into getting the greenhouse going into full steam, ordering chickens, incubating eggs for laying hens, and hopefully our bees awake fully in the springtime, and it'll be a full operating farm by May.
An important aspect of the farm's operations is their youth programs.
We work with about 70 youth every single week in the spring and fall, from about 10 or 11 different youth organizations, whether it's a high school or an after school program. And so they would come out to the farm for a few hours every week and do something and make something in the kitchen, feed the rabbits, shovel out the chicken coop, feed the pigs, transplant in the greenhouse, all really around food or food security or growing food.
Some of the foods grown and raised at Fort White Farms include pigs, rabbits, potatoes, kale, and many other vegetables. One way the farm sells these is through their CSA program.
CSA stands for Community Shared Agriculture, or Community Supported Agriculture. And it's an idea that has been around for a few years in terms of a different model of vegetable farming. Some people are doing it as a meat, if they raise meat or livestock as well. But our focus is vegetables, and we welcome people to invest in a share in our farm at the beginning of the season. So that would be at the end of winter or early spring. And then when vegetables are ready in the summertime, we will pick and bunch and wash whatever is ripe in our fields. And folks will come down to the farm and pick up their bin of vegetables, and it'll be a smattering of whatever is ripe that week, from radishes or kale, potatoes, tomatoes, carrots, onions, celery, etc.
When someone buys a share at the farm, they spend $495 at the beginning of the year, and in turn receive freshly grown vegetables once every week during the growing season.
An advantage for a farmer is that we as farmers would get paid throughout the year. So instead of having payment just when we sell our vegetables in June, July, August, September, we actually get paid throughout all of the seasons where we're still working in the greenhouse or during transplant season or weeding our vegetables in the field. We would get paid for that. Another is that the share is getting fresh local foods as well. So instead of going through a grocery store where maybe your food comes from farther away, you really get to know your farmer, the techniques that they use in growing all of your food, and you're getting a really high quality fresh vegetable for you or your family.
Many people don't purchase locally grown foods because they think they have higher costs. But that isn't necessarily the case.
I think people who want to pay really pay for really fresh food, our prices are on par with all of the farmers markets and other vendors and growers in Manitoba.
The farms, which produce 12 to 24 weeks of the year, have a notable effect on the community.
We've had lots of community impact. We lots of neighbors and community members stop by all the time. It's such a beautiful space to be at in any season, and the farm is just one aspect of that. So we see a lot of community residents come here. We're really friendly with all of our neighbors, being an agricultural operation as well. And we love when people drop by and learn about through our workshops and education programs, or just come for a picnic, or spend time on their lunch breaks going for a walk in the trails.
The farm hasn't only affected the community at large, it has also made a significant impression on Danielle.
I really love working here, I think, because I love seeing people opening their eyes in nature, and I love people stewarding things with their two hands, and I love being in the greenhouse. And it's really a rewarding job, not only to work in a beautiful setting with great coworkers and with amazing plants and animals, but it's fantastic to see people in this kind of environment, educational environment, really learning in an experiential way.
For more information about Fort White Farms and how you can get some of their foods, you can visit fortwhite.org. For Switch, I'm Joshua Hood.